A free vision means a vision free of prejudices. Prejudices are preconceived notions arrived at in the past based on past experience. Free vision is an open vision into the future as it is, without any interpretation, with the help of the data saved in our brain as memories. That means we think of things and beings based on our thoughts, on our memories arrived at in the dead past. Therefore, when we see things and beings at the present moment, our mind travels from the present moment into the dead past to identify what we experience at the present moment. At the same time, we think of present experience with some future expectation. If what we experience is present, we want to keep it in the future too. If the present experience is unpleasant, we want to get rid of it, for it not to come back in the future. Present experience, we want to come back in the unborn future too. Therefore, when we think of things based on prejudices, our mind gets distorted from the actual reality. Seeing things as they are is called in Buddha's language yatha bhuta jnana dassana, seeing things as they are, and accepting them as they are is called yatha labha santutti. That means without liking or disliking. We like pleasant experiences and we dislike unpleasant experiences. Liking leads to our attachment, called raga in Buddha's language. Disliking leads to our resentment, called dosa in Buddhist language. Both liking and disliking are based on the memories of our past experiences, the conclusion of things and beings that we have arrived in the past through past experience. That means we see the present moment in debt to the dead past while expecting some result in the future too. As I mentioned earlier, if the experience is present, we want to enjoy it even in the future. If the experience is unpleasant, we don't want to experience it in the future. Those are future expectations that we entertain as normal beings. to be enlightened. Buddha says in the last stanza of the Karaniyametta Sutta, our mind must be free from prejudices and endowed with an open vision. In Buddha language, ditthin anupagamma silava dassanena sampanno. Here ditthi means preconceived notions, past conclusions that we have arrived at based on our memories. Dassanena means what is happening at the moment. Ditthi is a past participle in language, in grammar. Dassanena is a present participle. It is attached to the present moment. Ditthi is attached to the dead past. Therefore, whenever we are using a ditthi or preconceived notion or a concept retained in our brain as memories, mentally our mind is living not in the present moment but in the past. And when we are expecting something through attachment or resentment, our mind travels from the present living moment into the unborn future. This state of psychological or mental traveling from the present moment to the dead past and to the unborn future is called samsarana in Buddha's language. Nisarana means free from motion, free from traveling into the dead past and into the unborn future while living at the present moment, here and now. What we call enlightenment, or what we call Nirvana, realized by enlightenment, is supposed to be here and now. Sandhittika means now. Ehipastika means here. The reality or truth or Nirvana is here and now, not in the dead past, nor in the unborn future. In such a state, we retain our pure mind, the original mind. The pure or the original mind is referred to by the Buddha as a radiant mind. At the page 18 of the volume 1 in the Anguttara Nikaya, Buddha made his statement regarding that original mind, pabhassaramidam bhikkhave cittam. The original mind is radiant, full of light. That means, metaphorically, not in the darkness of ignorance, accepting the present moment as it is, free from attachment called raga, resentment called dosa, and illusion called moha. In fact, Buddha has defined the state of Nirvana that one can attain through enlightenment. As ragakkhayo, dosakkhayo, mohakkhayo, idam muchyate Nibbana. The statement comes in the Nibbana Sutta, volume 4, page 474. That means enlightenment means living here and now. But the present moment too is instant. It's a only spark. It appears to disappear instantly. Because both mentally and physically, our life is in a process of constant changes. That is why the Greek philosophers, especially Heraclitus, who lived in the 15th century BC, said, "No one can step into the same river twice. Once we step into a river, we can't step back into it again, because when you go to step into for the second time, the river that was there in the first occasion has gone down." Similarly, both our mind and physical body are constantly changing. Not only physical body, but even the physical things. In fact, the entire universe is in a flux, constantly changing, retaining nothing permanently. That is the nature of our life, and the universe in which we spend our life, changing from moment to moment. Therefore, to experience life, we have to develop a scientific attitude free from prejudices. And we must have a free vision, a vision free of prejudices. Prejudgments that we have arrived at the past. Because every moment is a new moment, a fresh moment. To see it really, we have to see it here and now, instantly. And that seeing is a vision. In fact, enlightenment means arrive at a free vision, a vision free of prejudices that lead to our likes, dislikes and ignorance, called raga, dosa and moha in the Buddhist language. That means the enlightened one can live here and now, seeing the present moment as it is, and accepting the present moment as it is, without judging it to be good or bad, or pleasant or unpleasant. That is its nature. Both the pleasantness and unpleasantness are changing stages. What is pleasant at one moment may become unpleasant in another moment. What is unpleasant in one moment can become pleasant in another moment. Things are unreliable. And in this unreliable existence, free vision means seeing every moment as it is. That is the Buddhist meditation that leads us with the ultimate bliss of trances called Nirvana in Sanskrit and Nibbana in Pali. The word Nibbana in Pali means free from attachment, free from bondages. That means having a free vision. Nibbana is a vision, a free vision, free from bondages. Bana means bond, ni means negation, no bond. Bondless means free, and realizing it means a vision. Therefore, Nirvana or Nibbana is a free vision that can be experienced here and now. That is why Buddha says that Nirvana is sandhittika, now aipasika, can be seen here. It is here and now. Seeing here and now as it is means a free vision, the vision of an enlightened mind.